Where's my car? That was me saying that? As you pass closer to where the car was parked, you notice faint skid marks leading off to the north. Seriously, they stole the car. Follow the car tracks. The trail leads you into the wrecked city block surrounding New Reno. This is a different area? New Reno Chop Shop. Pep Gas. Huh. Okay. That's interesting. Here I thought it was my mistake. Be cool if you could shoot the gas pumps. They're probably empty anyway. This rusted piece of scrap metal cannot be restored. That's not our car. Yeah, these are not our cars. It's probably indoors. What is this? A movie poster for a horror film from pre-war days. Ripper? Like the video game? Not the one with Christopher Walken? Yeah, you guys stole my car. I'm taking my gun out. A circuit board with several unidentifiable parts, a microphone, and an inscription that reads Vault Tech Voice Recognition Module. Cool. It'll be cool to, like, turn that thing in. Oh, this is the, bathroom. Oh, there's a dude in there. Hello?
What you be need?
That's you, Sulik? Oh, so it is. Alright. I thought he was a guy working in here. That's interesting. You can't get to this area. Sure, I'll take that stuff. You can't get to this area unless your car is stolen, I guess. Would it be too much trouble for you to check under my hood? You're looking for talent? T-Ray's in the back, so don't bother going there. That's our car, isn't it? Yo! One of the Chop Shop boys. Wow, don't get many visitors. What can we do for you, miss? Grease-covered mechanic. Whistles. Thanks. Looking for some hot love? T-Ray's in the back, so don't bother going there. Damn, all them curves and me with no brakes. Wanna see my little grease monkey? Okay. Power generator. Glowing like that, pretty interesting. Chop Shop boys over here. Whistling. So is that it? For this area, just this. Yeah, might as well go talk to him then. If we get into a fight, I can take all this crap. Oh, Sulik's already back there. T-Ray! Damn! Look what just walked in. Looks like them upper body work rocks is finally paying off. What can I do for you, sweet thing? That car you have in the garage belongs to me. Your car? Woman, you don't even know what the hell you're talking about. That highwayman was scrap, left lying around, and guess what? Now it's ours. Of course, you got an issue with that. We could settle it here and now. What are you doing with the car? Jazz up the engine, clean out the interior, put a brass rope around the license plate, and kick some of that shit out of the trunk, make some room. When we're done, it'll be worth some serious chips to Mr. Bishop. I'm not paying him. You won't be selling that car to anyone. The car's mine. Yeah, I got an issue with it. Let's go, Chop Shop boy. How you like my death claw? A heavily muscled black man with thick glasses, a light beard, and an attitude. These guys are not tough. Holding a wrench. Boom! And boom! I'm gonna like looting this place. You won this time. Oh, they're running. Dead. Best to run. You're lucky I have to reload. Incoming. If they can run out of here. They don't seem to be running fast enough. He ran through the door. Who's this? Should have run out of here. All right. See what these guys have. Nice. Oh, I can't do that. Workbench. Junk. I don't want that. We already have two things of junk. More junk. I'm holding shift and she's not running. There we go. Time to pick the lock. This isn't really even worth locking, guys. Empty. Are you unlock it? It's empty. Failed. I need a crowbar. Really? That valuable? Take another tool. Super tool! Or a wrench? Typical wrench? Yeah, I'll take it. Seriously? Well, it is experience points. Just not a lot of it. Let's try it, since I'm in here. Empty. Cool. Oh, condoms. Rotten gun rum. Gamma gulp beer. Alright. So what about in here? This dude. Oh, he's got small energy cell. For my buddy. Cosmetics case. What is he doing that? Well, he's got interesting stuff. Locked. Failing. Let's try lock picks. Good. Okay. Oh, mount. Stuff. What's the difference here? Now we've got an extra blue, green. This one contains phosphorus green dye. Number two is slathered in spermicidal lubricant for added protection. What the hell? Yummy cinnamon bun flavor. Oh, geez. Get all this crap. There's a lot of crap. Ta-da. How is he doing anyway? Because I've been giving him a lot of stuff, but then again, I did take some stuff off him to sell. Oh, he's fine. He has plenty of room. Plenty of room. Alright, so... where is Sulik? Over here.
What you be needin'?
It's what you be needin'. You'll be ready to slay again. Change you back to... unarmed. And then best weapon. Yes. Mega power fist. Hell yeah. Alright, what else we got? Oh, we can get the other thing. I know I could have hit take all, but I didn't for some reason. Yay. Skip the radio, I'm gonna take I mean, skip the junk, I'd take that in the radio. We've got a locker over here. Then we got those lockers. Failing. Failing again? Yeah, got it. Third time's a charm. What we got in here? Oh, there's more lockpicks. Empty. Is that me making a noise? Got it. Empty, damn it. Oh well. XP, you know. How about these bodies? Did I loot them all? I don't think I did. Let me get this guy. Stuff. More junk. Oh, I saw some of his legs. Get the shoe. Switchblade. More stuff? Come on, of course. Can't get there because of Goris. Oh, rope. Sure, I'll take the rope. Never know when you need more rope. Oh, I go from that side after all. Alright. Yeah, I'll take all that stuff. Now, did they really take the stuff out of there, or not yet? Okay, it's still in there. I got a lot of crap in there, huh? Okay. Yeah, I'll just leave it like that. Alright, let's go. I don't even know what episode we're up to, I just keep going. So that's interesting, my car got stolen. And I found a new area and killed people. Off to Vault 13. Oh, not that far from it either. A swarm of mantis. Sure. Where are they? Oh, they're over there. have to do all the work, huh? You guys can't even attack. I had to reload. There you go. Thank you. This away. Talk to what's his name here? I'm trying to talk to him.
Hello, Andrea King. Have you found the part to fix the machine?
Yes, and here it is.
Thank you. Please go to the control room and replace the module.
Consider it done. Alright. Should be fairly straightforward. But you never know. There's always surprises in Fallout. Should I mention to this guy? He's correct, Vault City. Just in case there's a chance of failure. You guys stop walking in my way. You installed a module in the terminal. The system is repaired. Welcome, Vault Dweller. For your convenience, this Vault Tech terminal has been modified to respond to vocal commands. Please vocalize your command now. Run diagnostics. Please wait while I initiate diagnostic checks. Vault Tech appreciates your patience. Thank you for waiting. Diagnostic checks complete. All systems are working properly. After all, you're using Vault Tech. Back. Switch to keyboard input mode. Switching to manual interface mode. Manual interface mode initiated. For the convenience of others, this terminal will automatically revert to vocal interface mode once you have logged off. Please input command. Search database for anything of interest. After a bit of searching, you discover three files that might be worth a look. Vault Dweller Survival Guide, abridged version, Vault 13 Timeline, and Overseer Logs. Access Vault 13 Timeline. As you read over the beginning of the timeline, you find it interesting that no reason is given for why the vault didn't open 10 years after the Great War, as it was originally designed to. Browsing ahead, you don't find much of interest until the year 2161, when the vault's only working water chip breaks down. You feel a surge of pride as you read about your grandmother being selected for the important task of leaving the vault and securing the wasteland for a replacement water chip. However, it feels a little odd seeing your tribe's most revered legend told in a simple bullet point format. Continuing down the timeline, you read of your grandmother's success and subsequent exile, and how several other vault dwellers chose to join her rather than remain in the relative safety of the vault. You also discover that the Overseer was eventually tried and executed by the remaining vault dwellers. Wow. The final entry in the timeline is dated May of 2242. It seems that, for the first time, Vault 13 was sent an all-clear signal from an unknown source. After some debate, the Vault Dwellers decided to open the vault doors and see what awaited them on the surface world. There's no record of what happened to them after that. Access Vault Dweller Survival Guide, abridged version. Welcome to Vault 13, the latest in a series of public defense works from Vault Tech, your contractor of choice when it comes to the best in nuclear shelters. Vault Tech, America's final word in homes. The vault, a series of survival shelters, are designed from the ground up to provide the best chance for a good life following nuclear Armageddon. It is the duty of every American citizen to learn and use the skills necessary for a comfortable vault life. The best place to start is with a description of your new home. Important Vault 13 statistics. Starting construction date, August 2063. Ending construction date, March 2069. Starting budget, $400 billion. Final budget with interest, $645 billion. Total number of occupants, 1,000 at capacity. Total duration, 10 years at capacity. Number of living quarters, 100. Hot bunking required if at maximum capacity. Door thickness, 4 yards, steel. Earth coverage, 3,200,000 tons of soil at 200 feet. Computer control systems, think machine. Primary power supply, geothermal. Secondary power supply, General Atomics nuclear power backup systems. Power requirements, 3.98 megakilowatts a day, thinking. Stores, complete construction equipment, hydro-agricultural farms, water purification system from underground river, defensive weaponry to equip 10 men, communication, social, and entertainment files for total duration. To help vault dwellers record information, and information is extremely valuable, in fact, it might be the most valuable weapon we have against the end of civilization, so pay attention. Vault Tech has selected the Robco Industries Robco Pip-Boy 2000 as the personal information processor, PIP, of choice for its vault dwellers. So that's what Pip-Boy stands for. I probably knew that and forgot it from the first game. The Robco Pip-Boy 2000 is a handy device that you wear on your wrist. It's small, especially by today's standards, and it will store a goodly amount of information for you. And using modern super deluxe graphics to boot, really. Please refer to your Pip-Boy manual for more information. The key to a successful reintroduction of civilization following a massive scale nuclear war is people. Here at Vault-Tec, we are working to ensure to your fellow man and woman is up to the task of bringing America back from the dead. We believe that a positive attitude is one of the best tools at your disposal. Should you encounter any fellow vault dwellers displaying a less than positive attitude, you're encouraged to report them to your vault's overseer. Remember, once the doors are sealed, the overseer's word is law. Vault 13 comes prepared with the latest in survival equipment. The items in your storage containers will last 1,000 people over 10 years in comfortable and modern surroundings. When it is time to leave the vault and return to rebuild America, your friends at Vault Tech have provided you with everything that you will need. Thank you for taking the time to read the Vault Dweller's Survival Guide, abridged version. We at Vault Tech feel confident that you will love your new underground dwelling. Alright, interesting. I didn't know we'd find all this. Access Overseer Logs. Authorization required. Please enter password. Attempt to hack into it. You try everything you can think of, but you're unable to gain access. With a sigh of defeat, you return to the main menu. Guess password. Incorrect. What? I clicked it. Alright. I want to go back and read it. I don't want to log off yet. Password correct. All entries but one have been removed from the system. Final entry in the Overseer's logs is still accessible. Alright, let's see what this Overseer has to say. This is it. Consider these my final words, as I doubt I'll live to write another entry. Oh no, the people of the Vault have spoken, and they've made it clear, quite clear, that they want my head. I knew that this day would come ever since she managed to rile them up by doing the impossible. Sure, she saved all our lives, but she also ruined everything. Let it be known that I took little joy in exiling our great hero, but I had no choice in the matter. Her adventures in the outside world had changed her too much. She was too great a threat to the project. Had I let her remain among us, she might have uncovered the true nature of the vaults. Really? True nature? And jeopardized this experiment. Even if she didn't, she'd at least inspire others to venture outside, which would be just as bad. Need a drink here. She simply had to go. There was no other option. But even that wasn't enough. No, I'm afraid the damage had already been done. I allowed her most stubborn supporters to follow her into exile, and then tried to reassert my control over those who remained. But it was no use. I'd already been vilified. So be it. The only thing I'm guilty of is an entire lifetime of carrying out the demands of our great nation. Like a title. Great nation. My only regret is that Vault 13 is not likely to complete the social experiment. Once I've been disposed of, I feel certain the others will leave the vault. Not right away, of course. I've instilled too much fear in them, of the outside world. But eventually they're bound to overcome that fear. I have very little faith that Vault 13 will remain closed until 2277, as the experiment dictates. Real experiment. This is an experiment. I'm afraid I have failed my duty as overseer. I can only hope that the rest of the public vaults involved in the societal preservation program have been more successful. To my superiors, who I'm certain will one day read this, forgive me, and may God bless America. Search for any other files that contain information on societal preservation program. After hours of scouring through the computer's archives, you are unable to find anything else that mentions the societal preservation program. As you give up your search, you vow never again to waste so much time staring at a computer monitor. You've got me confused with someone else. You see, I'm not the Vault Dweller, I'm the Chosen One. A light blinks on the terminal as it makes various clicking and whirling sounds. After several seconds, text appears on the monitor. Okay, so I'm guessing it's not speaking, it's text. Sorry, I did not understand your command. Please repeat your command, making sure to speak directly into the microphone in a clear and precise manner. Vault-Tec apologizes for any inconvenience. Thank you. I guess I can hack into it. I was wondering if you get some, you know. That is cheesy, though. I mean, I've already read it. Why would my character be doing that? Where's Jimmy? Oh, he's over here. Let's see if he has anything to say. You should let Gruthar know that you fixed the computer. I sure will. I wonder if he has anything to say. Nope. Alright. Gruthar. So, you learn about the vault experiments and the roles of the various vaults. Alright, so we gain 1,000 XP. You learn about the history of Vault 13 and the Overseer's role in the vault's experiments. 800 experience points. So, guess what?
You have restored my faith in humans. I thank you for all that you have done for the pack. Is there something that I can do for you in return?
You said you would let me know if you found a Gek here. Did you locate one? I already stole it.
Yes, there was a Gek in the vault storage room. However, it is missing. I am sorry that I cannot give it to you as a reward for all your generous help.
That's okay. I'll try to locate one elsewhere. I already stole it. let's get the hell out of here. They really aren't very trusting. Too trusting for their own good. So we gain 10 karma and another 5,000 experience points. Hmm. 9,000 XP and change, and we'll be up another level. Sweet. Alright, so that's done. Knocking him down. I am now idolized in Vault 13. Okay. Not completely sure now. Well, we can explore the Sierra Army base. We can go back to San Francisco and install that NavCom computer part. I'm like, who the hell's coming? That's Lenny all the way back there. We have some various little things on the map down here, like this bridge and stuff. Well, that might be where we found the Grim Reaper. I'm gonna go check it out, though. Yeah, we've got small stuff like that to take care of. So. Yeah, we'll probably tackle whatever's closest. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.